means. Tonight is a very special night here with the biggest, the largest event called the Big Bone Bash. We have the annual San Jose High School. All the alumni is all getting together called the Big Bone Bash. And I want to know why is it called Big Bone? And we are back here at the Corinthian Ballroom in downtown San Jose for the Big
Bone Bash.
Here we got
Bill Clyden, San Jose High Alumni President. This is our 27th year of having the Big Bone Bash. We've been at six or seven different locations. This is our second year here, and we love it.
What is the importance of this Big Bone Bash here?
Well, it's just to bring the community together. It started about San Jose High. Now it's got San Jose and Lincoln, which is our rival, and now we've opened it open to the public, a Thanksgiving-type party. So that's basically what it is.
It's happening every year. How long is it?
27.
We're back with another attendee and another alumni. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Kristen Canals in class of 87, and I'm really happy to be here at Corinthian Ballroom.
Such a proud alumni.
Absolutely, absolutely. Proud of the Bulldogs. My brother from my brother down to me. So all seven of us went to San Jose High.
years young. Let's give a big round of applause, Mr. Bill Clyden. Where are you at? Bring your ass up here, man. We can cuss when you're grown. Hurry up.
Just love. seats so that we find out how many seats we have available for those that don't have seats. Dinner is going to be a little bit late. It's about running about 50 minutes late. 50-50 raffle tickets. And we have a lot of hors d'oeuvres still left in the back. It's going to be in 10-minute increments per table group. So the first group of tables is going to be 1 through 10. And they'll probably start at 7.
We're pushing 400 plus, so we'd like to get all of those who have dinner tickets to please take your seats. It will also help us to find out how many empty seats that we have so people can join us. We have a great program for you this evening. We are going to be taking class photos. That's what these chairs are up here.
Hello, Bulldogs! Go Bulldogs! In the 60s, all right, go Bulldogs!
It's $100 a person, and in addition to scholarships, about $50,000 worth, we also help kids who are impoverished, kids who are disabled, or kids who are victims of natural catastrophes like Katrina. Many people as possible can join us August 9th, and the second Saturday of every August every year.
The photographer needs some space around the camera because it's wide angle. He's going to take three shots. Your class of 66. Class of 67, come on up. 7. Round of applause for class of 69.
History and a lot of materials. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Thank you, Mark. There is a special plaque that's going to be given to Dave Nelson. Dave Nelson, where are you? Please. It was given to us by with Norm Mineta. So we have very famous people tonight in our school. Where is the plaque?
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to present this plaque to the teacher and coach who came into San Jose High in 1963 as a football coach and wrestling coach and swimming coach, and a drinking partner at Nishioka at 6th Street. Remember Nishioka? Ebra.
That's
yeah. Coach Dave Nelson.
A lot of trouble reading. That's why I became a teacher, so I have to have my friend here read it. No, I know how to read.
Well, anyway, this plaque is given to a special person that treated us pretty good. In fact, he did a great job in being a mentor. This is why he's getting this plaque. It says thank you to Coach Dave Nelson for your coaching, honesty, and most of all, for being an all-around great human being who treats everyone with respect and care. You're one in a million with lots of love and gratitude from your students and athletes of San Jose High School in 1963-1965.
It's an honor to have this award, as you all know. And the funny thing about this, the guy that gave it to me is a former Hawaiian, or he's once a Hawaiian, always a Hawaiian. And my son lives in Hawaii, so I feel doubly honored for this. I want to thank you all for coming.
He just donated a $25 gift certificate to Casa Palmas. Wait, is that considered? Yeah.
64, 65. Dessert.
That's my dad's best friend. My father passed away about
706-7755. Hi, what's your name? Hi, Joanne. Did you go to San Jose High?
Green ticket.
No, you're just here having fun.
We're party crashers.
Oh, okay. Party crashers. That's an interesting career. So who went to San Jose High?
He invited us.
Oh, you invited.
Green ticket.
Wow, you just brought your entourage with you, didn't you?
This is my harem.
This is your harem. And what's your name?
Phil.
And Phil, when did you graduate San Jose High?
747.
He got kicked out?
747.
They kept me in. I just...
I put it to good use tonight.
I went there to eat my lunch.
64. All right, so I'm going to ask each one of you your name. Okay, hey, what's your name?
Joanne.
All right, hi, what's your name?
Smiley.
And we already got your name, but say it again.
Phil.
All right, Phil.
My other half.
Your other half. Hey, Phil's wife.
That's my best friend over there.
Hi.
Best friend, Larry.
Larry, and?
And what?
Lori.
Thank you. This is your better half, yeah?
That's me.
And what's your name?
172.
It was Herrera.
Did you go to San Jose High also? All right.
The idea of
Hi, did you go to San Jose High?
No, I went to Willow Glen.
You did? What are you guys doing here? You went to San Jose High, class of 1964. What's your name? Wow, did you guys meet in high school?
Yeah, I graduated in 81.
All right.
Nephew Maddox, he turned 7. I'm super Thea when I walk in that door. He sees me on TV and he thinks I'm a movie star. I'm just in a meeting in a council chamber.
Celebrity now.
I'm a celebrity to those kids. And that's what makes me really humble. And that's what makes me appreciate this experience a whole lot more.
I think Gabby had a question in the back.
Gabby Charles Lopez, I'm a new board member of LCSD.
A lot of the resources that other candidates might have. So it helped us kind of navigate those waters. It helped me navigate those waters and come through. Anybody else?
Yeah, I think for the city of Milpitas and serving in a city where the position is a part-time position, it definitely has been a strength to be a staffer before, because I really literally hit the pavement on day one. I was a staffer, so I'm able to do my own scheduling, I'm able to write my own memos, I'm able to ask the right questions when I'm reading language that's coming through my desk. And that is actually a strength that I know no one else started with on the council. And even staff members have told me, you know exactly what questions to ask and you know exactly what answers to look for. And that's really important when you're making decisions for thousands of people. And so I definitely don't think it may be a requirement, but I do feel definitely it has enhanced my ability to work on day one.
Definitely.
And I think it can also help your relationship with staff mm-hmm. in terms of you've been maybe where they've been. Yes. And so there's a trust, I think, that's automatically established in terms of they know that you're not trying to put them on the spot or do any kind of surprises. And I think that leads to a little bit of openness, especially when you're trying to discuss really hard policy issues. So I think that can
problem
be
solving.
Problem solving. Yes, problem solving. Policy issues. Yeah. Right, kind of in the beforehand, helpful. Before yes. before the discussion at the council meeting. It can be very helpful.
I want to take a step back on campaigning, which you mentioned, and I want to direct this question actually to Ellen and Maya. 4 years ago, you both ran for office, and although the first time didn't go in your favor, you were both ultimately successful in your second run for office. What advice would you give to Latinos who want to run for office the first time, or what advice do you wish you could give yourself 4 years ago as a first-time candidate?
Oh, no pressure because my mom's here. who she always reminds me. She's like, Ellen, you're Latina. Don't remember that. I think that being multiracial, you have all these different experiences where you already know that you're a minority. So it's like you're a woman, you're a minority, and then you're Asian and you're a minority, and then you're Latino and you're a minority. So you have all these things, I think, stacked against you, which is gonna lead to just a different approach to campaigning, I would say. And 4 years ago, I think the biggest takeaway that I had is trust your gut. Mm-hmm. And the first time I ran, I was 29, 30, and campaigns are so noisy. And having volunteered on campaigns, I never thought that. But when it's you and when you're the candidate, there's so many things trying to pull your attention. Is it the field? Is it walking? Is it press? And you have to find a way to drown out that noise and stay true to yourself. And I think that comes down to a set of values. And I think kind of growing up, multiracial, your set of values and your core can be such a strength if you allow yourself to, you know, to hear that within yourself. So I think that, and in talking with Maya, we kind of said, I asked her, I was like, what are you doing differently? And she's like, all the things that I want to do differently, I'm doing them. And that really helped inspire me to say, yeah, you know what, there are things that I might have regrets on. And instead of thinking about them, I'm going to push them aside, and I'm going to move forward, and I'm going to, do that op-ed that I had wanted to do. I'm going to do that.